Now we are starting a new chapter, alternating current. This is a 12th chapter, electromagnetic induction. I have already explained you. So in alternating current, here in the figure you can see that when a closed coil is rotated rapidly in a strong magnetic field, the black arrow shows you a uniform magnetic field, and the blue one is your closed coil. Then the number of magnetic lines of flux lines passing through the coil change continuously. As the coil will rotate in the magnetic field, the number of magnetic lines of forces passing through this coil will keep on changing. And when it will keep on changing, what will happen? An induced EMF will be produced, and hence an induced current will be produced. Now here the mechanical energy expanded in rotating the coil appears as electrical energy in the coil. As the coil is being rotated, the direction of the induced current will be given by Fleming's right hand rule. It depends on the direction in which the coil is being rotated. So if you have gone thoroughly with the topics taught before this, you will be able to understand further. So if A is the area of the plane of coil and B is the magnetic field, then the flux linked with the coil will be given by BA cos theta. This is theta. If the area cross section is A and the magnetic field is given by B, then the flux linked to the coil, this already we have discussed earlier, will be given as BA cos theta. Right, here we are talking when there is only one term. Now, theta is equal to omega t. Now, what is theta and what is omega t? In class 11th also we have seen that omega is the angular velocity. As the coil is rotating round and round, it is having an angular velocity, and theta is the angular distance. Okay, distance is equal to velocity into time. So this is omega, theta is equal to omega into t, t is the time taken, and hence phi b can be written as ba cos omega t. Now the rate of change of magnetic flux, will be phi b upon d dt of ba cos omega t. Now b and a, b is the magnetic field and a is the area cross section of the coil, will be a constant value, and hence it becomes ba d dt of cos omega t. Now the differentiation of cos omega t, when we started off in class 11th, I had already given you the differentiation and the integration of the entire thing. And basically the math students must be knowing the differentiation and integration now up till now, but still only the biology students. If you find difficulty in the differentiation and integration part, you can ask me and I can explain you separately. But there is no excuse for math students. I expect you to know the differentiation and integration. So when we are differentiating this, what we get is, this will be BA minus omega cos omega t. Sin omega t changes into minus sin. Cos omega t changes into minus sin. That is differentiation of, you can note it down somewhere, differentiation of cos t is minus sin t. Now if there is a value here, what happens? It comes here. Omega t ka fir se hoga. T is being differentiated with respect to t, that will be 1, and omega will be left. So we are having BA or minus BA omega sine omega t. Right. So this is what? This is the rate of change of magnetic flux. Now by Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, the EMF induced in each turn of the coil is minus d phi b upon dt. We have seen the Faraday's law. There are two Faraday's law. According to the Faraday's law, the induced EMF in each turn of the coil is minus d phi b upon dt. If the coil has n number of turns, then this is shown as the induced EMF, which can also be written as v minus n b a omega sine omega. This becomes the value of the induced EMF or potential. Now, what you see is that the magnitude of the EMF induced in a coil rotating in the magnetic field changes continuously with time. The maximum value of sine omega t, the maximum value of sine omega t is 1. So when this will be 1, the value of potential will be maximum. So in that case, we mean is that V0, that is the maximum peak value, will be written as NBA. This will be the peak value of the voltage, and hence this formula can be written as V is equal to V0 sine omega t. That is NBA. Right, NBA omega, because sine omega t will be 1. So NBA omega will be its maximum value. So V will be written as, one thing I want to clarify here is, as by the Faraday's law, V is equal to minus d phi b upon dt. Okay, so minus already was here, so both the side minus gets cancelled out, and we are left with this value. Finally, the potential comes out to be V is equal to V0 sine omega t, and this is the value of the potential. Now listen very carefully that I also send you a video here to show you the motion of the coil in the magnetic field. So you see, in the first half rotation of the coil, the voltage induced in the coil rises from 0 to a maximum and then again becomes 0. While in the next half rotation, the induced voltage rises from 0 to a maximum in opposite direction and again becomes 0. This process is repeated again and again. The current which flows through a circuit due to this alternate voltage also changes continuously between 0 and the maximum value, and flows in one direction in the first half rotation and the opposite direction in the next half rotation. This type of current is called alternating current. Like alternating voltage and alternating current at any instant is given by I is equal to I0, or you can say I is equal to I0 sine omega t, where I0 is the maximum value of the current. And when we plot a graph, we see that we are taking V and I both on this, okay, the positive cycle and the negative cycle. So if this is showing you the voltage, the current is following in the, that is, this is the peak value for V0, that is the voltage, and this is the peak value for I. So this is the graphical representation between V and I, that is the alternating current and the voltage, and is called as sinusoidal graph or wave.